Hello everyone, welcome back to my LuaSTG tutorial series. Today we're going to expand further upon our knowledge regarding bosses in the engine, and also learn new stuff overall. This tutorial was a suggestion from some people in the Bullet Hell Engine's Discord server, so if you have anything that you would like to see in these tutorials, feel free to come there and give her a suggestion on what you'd like to hear me talk about. So let's not stall further upon and start the tutorial. Alright, so opening up the project file from the last tutorial, we're gonna continue from where we left off. Remember those other files that you downloaded in the last video? Let's use them now. First, you have to load those pictures using the load image node. You can do that inside the resources folder that came with our project template. I created a folder called images inside it as well to help organize it. After you load it, you will see some parameters, but don't mess with them yet, as nothing in them are of interest to us at the moment. Next, you're going to-
Chai, please stop using the editor or else I will first try you. Thank you!
Just ignore him, Zeno just really doesn't like using the editor. Anyways, coming back, now I introduce you to the boss background node. You can find it in the boss tab. It doesn't have any parameter excluding from the background's name, of which I named Marissa BG, but you have to insert layers in it. In the same tab that you got the boss background node from, place two layer nodes as children of it. As you can see, it has a few interesting parameters for us to use. In image, you can select the images we just loaded inside the editor. On the bottom layer, you can use the background number 00, and at the top one, 01. The isStyle parameter is a true or false check for the engine to know if it's a seamless image or an image that can be looped. This is especially useful for images that we make scrolling, of which we are going to do on the background number 01. Position just specifies a starting position based on the middle of the playing field of the image. Rotation is just the orientation of the image. Let it be 0 for now since our images are already correctly orientated. Velocity X and Y does exactly what it says. It makes the image go in the speed desired. A positive X value makes it go to the right, while a positive Y value makes it go upwards. In this case, in the background number 01, let's make the Y velocity 0.5. Omega means if the image itself spins around itself. Positive values make it go clockwise, while negative value makes it go counterclockwise. The higher the value, either positively or negatively, the faster it will spin. This may not work on layers that have the isStyle enabled. Then we have blend mode, of which are some options you can select to make the layer blend with the ones below it. And finally, scale. It determines the size of the image itself, being 1 the default size. Let's make it a little bit smaller than the actual image file, so put in both the first and second value, of which corresponds to X and Y, 0.7. As you can also see, the layer node already came with 3 children inside of itself. Remember when I explained the siblings of the onInit node in the last video? Well, here are 3 of them. onInit describes an action for the layer to make when it is first created. OnFrame describes an action for the layer to make every frame, and OnRender describes an action for the layer to make when displaying itself, or rendering in literal terms. Now we're done making the bars a background. It's simple, but it works. You can leave the bottom layer unaltered as it is there just as a base background. Go back to the boss defined node and click it on its onInit node. There, a familiar face will come up. Remember the spellcard background parameter? Well, now you're gonna select the background we just created in it. After you did that, let's start playing the game. Just noting, I banned the bullets that we created in the last tutorial so that we can see better the background this time. Banning means telling the game to ignore a centered node that we place on the management field. In this case, I banned the repeat node inside the spell card, making the bullets not spawn. To ban a node, simply click on the node you want to ban and press F4, or you can right-click on it and select the ban option. Fantastic! Now that we've completed the boss background, we can try making some more spell cards. First off, I'll start by turning the spell card we made in the last video into a non-spell. In case you didn't remember how to make non-spells, simply erase the name of the spell card and the game will treat it as a non-spell. I also unbanned the shots. We can forget about adding some sounds too. Go inside the repeat node and you can play play sound effect node, found in the audio tab before the wait node that is inside of it. In the play sound effect node, we can see some parameters, such as name, which is the name of the sound effect being played. You can see a preview of the sound when you're gonna select them. I personally selected Kira00 as the sound that we'll play, which is a magic key sound effect. In volume, you can select the audio volume when playing the sound. I recommend not messing with this unless it is really inaudible. Then we have pan, which is the auto panning. It comes with a small code that pans the shot sound to the ear where the shot is closest to. So for example, if the audio is played on the right side of the screen, it'll be panned to the right and vice versa. Positive values go to the right and negative ones go to the left. Then there's ignore default volume, which makes the engine ignore the, well, default sound volume. Since this is a really simple addition, I'll skip showing it here and jump into the next poker directly. To create a new poker, just select this poker node in the boss tab and place it after the one that is already inside the defined boss. In this new poker, instead of using another create simple bullets node, I'll create a defined bullet instead. A defined bullet, as I said in the last video, is a bullet that can be given specific operations and more arguments too than a simple bullet node. I'll create another folder inside of resources and name it bullet and lasers. Inside of the folder, I'll place a defined bullet node. Just like bosses, a defined bullet node can have a name and a difficulty attached to it. In this case, let's make it all. In the onInit node of this bullet, we have some properties such as parameter list, which are arguments that you can pass to the bullet. For example, if you define a variable, of which I'll explain how later, you can make it so that a bullet would ask for that variable, and the boss will provide it if you list that the bullet needs it in this parameter list. In the style, you select the bullet graphic and in color, its color. Just like in simple bullets, stay on create and destroy will also have the same meaning. I'll make it a big blue star. You can now attach a task to this on init node, and we will begin doing things for the bullet to follow there. First, you can add a set velocity node from the object tab as a child of the task, and we'll see some parameters for it. First, we can see target, which is what the velocity node is going to affect. In our case, self, which is the bullet that the node is located inside. Then we have velocity, which is the speed of the bullet. Then we got angle, which is the angle of the bullet will travel towards. Then we have a check for aim to player, which will either be true or false. Remember that if the bullet is going to be aimed at a player, make sure that angle is equal to 0, otherwise it will calculate angle in relation to the player's position. And lastly, we have side rotation, which is to tell if the bullet's graphic will follow the orientation of the bullet. As you can see in the picture, instead of using numbers in velocity and angle, I wrote variable names. Variables can hold elements, such as numbers or strings that are words, for example. In this case, what I mean by putting this is that we're not going to define the speed and angle directly here in the bullet, rather only when we're going to create it. In that case, go back to the onInit node of this bullet and place speed, comma, angle in the parameter list. Now, when we create this bullet, it will ask for those two parameters to be filled. Let's go back to the spell card that we created and create the bullet after the move to node. In this create bullet node, we can specify the bullet that we want, the spawn position and the parameters. Clicking on the parameters, we will see a box with the available parameters to be filled, of which are those we use when defining the mouse bullet. In this case, I set the speed as 3 and the angle as minus 90. That will make the bullet go downwards in the velocity of 3. Let's start playing the spell card and see if it works. Remember, you can instantly play the spell card directly if you select the spell card node of the tag you want to play and click on the test spell card button. Fabulous, it works! Now, can you see the potential on this bullet? You can use whatever node, of course, within the limits inside that bullet and make it do all sorts of stuff, like spawning ever more bullets within itself. But also, let's try making lasers. Lasers are as equally simple as bullets, so I'll make it real quick to show you since my video time is getting close. Place a defined laser node found in the laser tab after the defined bullet we made just now. It has a usual name and difficulty parameters as always. On its onInit node, we can see some parameters here. Of course, the parameter list, just like I explained, color, which is the laser's color, and style, which is the laser graphic. Then we have the head, body, and tall length of the laser, and its width. It's pretty much self-explanatory. About the node and head size, we'll talk about that later. As you can see, another node already came inside the laser, which is a laser turn on node. Inside it, we have target, which is the laser itself, time, which is the amount of frames it'll take for the laser to turn on, play sound effect, which asks if it should play laser sound effect, and wait in the stacks, so that you decide if the laser will wait for the turn on to be completed before proceeding to the next nodes. I personally turned wait in this task to false. Now you can also use the velocity node we use in the bullet as well to decide the laser's trajectory. This time I didn't use any parameter, but I enabled aim to player and set the velocity to 2. Now place the create laser node in front of the Mars bullet and let's try playing it. Wonderful, just as expected. How about we try curvy laser now? Define a bent laser after our straight laser and do the same steps as the previous one. The parameters should be self-explanatory, but this time, instead of the set velocity node, I used the set acceleration node and made it aim to the player so that we can see more of the bendiness of the curvy laser. I put it inside a repeat node so that the laser always aims to the current laser position. Create a bent laser after a straight one in this power card and let's see how it goes. Nice! It worked as expected. For now, this was a video. It was kinda short, but we hit the video time limit. If it were longer, I would miss the video schedule. So I hope you liked it, and I hope you liked it, and I'd like to see you again in the next tutorial. Thanks again, and goodbye.